joins us now from Capitol Hill. Congressman, thank you so much for being with us.
Oh, thank you for having me.
So where do you see the need for this legislation? Is there a curtailing right now of valuable medical research because of it's an ambiguity about whether it's legal?
There's amazing medical cannabis research going on in the world today. Unfortunately, it's principally happening in Israel, in the United Kingdom, and in Germany, in places that don't have a national government that prohibits that research from occurring. So today, we've introduced legislation with 25 co-sponsors from all over the ideological spectrum that breaks the logjam we've had in Congress, where some have said we cannot reform our cannabis laws because we don't have the research to support it, and then at the same time, we frustrate the very research that could unlock cures for the American people. So it's very exciting to have a broad spectrum of the Congress supporting legislation to protect research so that nobody doing that research will be worried that the FBI or the Department of Justice will be knocking in their door anytime soon.
A broad spectrum, without a doubt, and congratulations on getting that many people together. At the same time, it's not all of them. Are you getting resistance from some members of Congress who say, I am not in favor of recreational use of marijuana, and I'm worried that this is a step in that direction?
There are some who hold that view. In fact, there are strong headwinds in my own party on the issue of cannabis reform, but I really believe that if we can show research that says that children with epilepsy can live better lives, that veterans will be able to deal with the challenges of PTSD so that they can have jobs and productive relationships in their families, that those will be the stories that will be persuasive to Republicans that to this point in time have had recalcitrant opposition to any type of cannabis reform. This will be the first time a cannabis reform bill is voted on in a committee ever during Republican control of the Congress, the first time since 1978, since before I was even born, that there'll be a congressional committee looking at an issue like this. So it's very exciting.
But Congressman, it's an election year, so what are the chances that it will pass?
I think the fact that it's an election year increases the probability of passage because you've got a lot of Republicans, frankly, running for re-election in seats where cannabis reform is very popular, where medical marijuana is popular. And so if we're not going to take marijuana off of the list of Schedule I drugs, which I support and which I think we should do, at a very minimum, we need an opportunity politically for Republicans to vote for research and cures and medical application of cannabis that it has ubiquitous popularity all across the country.
How concerning is it to you that the Attorney General is now pursuing a new federal crackdown on marijuana?
Well, the Attorney General wants to execute on yesterday's cannabis policies. I want to write the rules for tomorrow. We need to move forward. We need to get past this dogmatic approach to cannabis where people think that anyone who uses it for medical reasons is somehow a bad person. That is a flawed, dogmatic viewpoint, and today signals that more and more Republicans want to lead into the future and unlock those cures, and we want to divorce ourselves from the dogmatic past that has limited our ability to do this important work.
Congressman, you picked up a very important endorsement in Chairman Goodlatte, without a doubt, a very influential conservative, I must say, a representative from Roanoke. Is it a coincidence that Chairman Goodlatte's not running for re-election?
I don't know. I know that throughout his career, Chairman Goodlatte has been very skeptical of any cannabis reform policy, so it is monumental that we're even earning the support of people who have been historic adversaries on the issue of cannabis. And now Chairman Goodlatte, to his great credit, has stepped forward, has led on the issue, and is helping us craft policies that will democratize access to the very research and to the very cures that can improve quality of life for millions of Americans.
So Congressman, what is the position, if any, of the administration on your bill? I mean, we have heard about Jeff Sessions, the Attorney General, if not absolutely mastering a crackdown, saying it's okay for federal prosecutors to go after marijuana across the country. Is the administration supporting you? Are they opposed to you, or are they off on the side?
Well, I don't know that we've got historically good relationships right now between the White House and the Department of Justice on all things. I will say that in my conversations with the president has always supported medical marijuana. The president's a compassionate guy, and so my hope is that from the White House, we'll be able to get some leadership. I do believe the president will sign this bill if we can get it in front of him, and the smoke signals we're seeing today seem to indicate that we're going to have that opportunity.
Congressman, thank you so much for your time. Republican Congressman Matt Gaetz.